Everybody talks about the literary community in Seattle because you can't swing a dead cat without hitting a writer, but I was never part of a literary community. I think poets do this better than prose writers. They have a community. I'm not thoroughly convinced that prose writers, fiction writers, are really much of a community. About a few weeks before I left Seattle, I was invited to join the Seattle Seven, which was this small group of writers that met to, I don't know, have coffee and console each other, or, you know, inspire each other or whatever. Garth Stein was one of the writers. But then I moved and I came here, and Miami, there's a writer's community here. It's really different. I think it's like, we're like the French underground here, you know, because you think of Seattle and you think of writers, and you think of Miami, and that's not where your mind goes. And I don't even really think there would be a literary community here if it weren't for Mitchell Kaplan. He invented it out of whole cloth. You know, he started the bookstore Books and Books, and then a few years later, with the kind of arrogance of youth, he thought, oh, and I'll start a literary festival. And I know, like, Les Stanford has told me, they were friends back then, and he just thought, this guy is nuts. But, you know, if you build it, they will come. And so it's this strange thing that there actually is a literary community here. I'm part of it. I teach in an MFA program. All of my friends are writers, so yeah, I guess I'm part of a literary community. It's not a walk-in town. We live in Coconut Grove, but unless you live on the beach or in Coconut Grove, you're stuck with being in your cars, and it's a long way to get from one place to another. And it's not the kind of place that breeds community.